Hey, I'm Gregori Klosman and you're watching Loop TV. I always loved music. I was a piano player since a young I was young, and I'm a kid of the dance culture. You know, Ultranate, Erick Morillo. I like to move it. It was like my first influence. But then I heard new songs from Daft Punk in 1997 with their first album, their debut album. And I was really stunned by the sound, and I wanted to do that. Like, I want to do that kind of stuff. I'm a geek with the computer, so I wanted to tweak sounds. Yeah, that's basically how I fell in love with house music and production. So he played a lot of my tracks. The first one was Fucking Down. He was one of the first DJ supporting Fucking Down with I did it with Tristan Garner. And I just thanked him by Twitter, like almost 2 years ago, one year ago. And his answer on Twitter was, "Yeah, like your son, we should work together." So we just get contact, touch base like this first, and we decided to do some remixes together. First one was for Nervo Irresistible, and then I started a track at my own home studio. And I asked him, "Do you want to do the track with me?" He said, "Yes." It was my factor. So we couldn't have this chance to work together in the studio yet because he's really busy, and I'm getting busier this year. But yeah, we were talking a lot via Skype or on the phone, working a lot with email, and he knows exactly what's working on the dance floor, arrangement-wise. And so that's the way we work, you know, just talk a lot. Yeah, we work just together, and we have that chance to be able to test our tracks directly on the weekend at our own gigs. So we know what's wrong, what's cool, what to keep, what to change. That's what. I have a lot of upcoming stuff. In the next couple of months, I made a remix for Lady Gaga. It will be released on the remix album on November 21st. It's Born This Way, the remix album. Remix for Americano, a really nasty bass line. I have also just made a remix for David Guetta's new single, Titanium, featuring Sia. He just played it yesterday as a premiere, world premiere at DJ Mag party, so I'm really happy about it. And I'm getting early support from a lot of my DJ friends here. So I'll be happy about it. A new track called Camilla. I don't have a label or released it yet, but I also get a great support from my friends and from a lot of fans also. And regarding gigs, I have my first gig in UK. So it'll help me. November 12th with Chuckie in Get Crush of Birmingham. So I'm really excited about this first gig in the UK. December 17, I have the Dirty Dutch Blackout. It's gonna be a big party in Amsterdam at Rai. It's a big venue, like 30,000 people playing back to back with Chuckie. It's gonna be amazing. Oh, I think both. I mean, the reason I produce into the studio is I want to play the track live. It's connected because my music is really clubby. So there is no sense if I just produce music for other DJs. I'm a DJ first, and I learned being a DJ at the same time I learned being a producer. So for me, it's just connected. I want to do the best music in the studio. I really enjoy being in the studio because we are like alone. You can think about your music, work hard, and then you can just see the result of your work in the club. So the same for me. Yeah, I used them, the 2000, CDG 2000, I used them with the record breaks prior to the gigs. I just set my old playlist, create hot loops, hot cues, and on the USB stick or SD card, it's really easy because you can just access really fast to your, some tools, a cappellas, and then you can make a perfect loop for the beat match, and I love them. For now, I don't use any hardware, just software. I use a lot of the Waves plugin, also Sonox, Oxford plugins, FabFilter, Whoa, FabFilter Simplon, all the any plugin that can help me to tweak the sounds in a different way. And regarding VSTs, I use a lot of Silent Nexus, Zebra, Ace. Yeah, most of the time. I use a lot of sample packs from different companies. But back in the days, I was using a lot of pre-made loops. Now I build my own loops with samples because it's better to have your own loop. Social networking is definitely leading the business right now because you can get in touch with your fan base like this. With your, even now I can tweet. I'm doing an interview. I tweeted actually, and yeah, it's important because you can push some previews, information about your gigs. Everything is going on Facebook and Twitter right now. And yeah, like even the DJ Mag Top 100 poll, you had to vote on Facebook, so it proved how important it is today.